Hey everybody, Bill Hunt here, coming at you from Cedar Crest High School in Lebanon, Pennsylvania. And again, I'd like to thank you all for checking out my series of behind the stories behind the songs. This is going to be a very important one. This deals with the beginning of Cry Wolf. So, Fear No Evil had just broken up. Things went very badly after our show at the Lebanon Valley Mall, and the band was no longer together. So I thought I was going to take some time away from being in a band and just play music on my own and maybe write some songs. But it didn't take very long. I was, me and my mom went into a guitar shop, which I'll be broadcasting from at some point in the very near future. We went into a guitar shop in Lebanon and we're just talking to the guy that ran the place because we knew him. And I was looking at different guitars, and in came two guys that were talking to him about trying to put a band together, and they were looking for a singer and a lead guitarist for the same style of music that I played. I didn't know the bass player Bob, but I did know the drummer Henry from his previous band. They had come out to see Fear No Evil play, so we kind of knew each other a little bit, but not real well. So when they came in, said they were looking for somebody, I happened to be available. I wasn't in Fear No Evil anymore. So I said I'd love to get something going, and we decided to get together at the rehearsal place in Lebanon and see how things sounded. Now, originally, the way the band was going to be was we were going to do cover songs and some original material. But even that first time we got together, one of the songs we played was Panama from Van Halen, which is pretty cool. Especially considering years later I was in a Van Halen tribute band. But that's another story for another time. But interesting story about the way the band got together, Cry Wolf got together, was originally Bob was going to play guitar instead of bass, but bass players were so hard to find that Bob decided to switch to bass, which I thought was really cool. And we made the decision early on that all three of us were going to sing different songs. So I thought that was very cool also. When we got that first rehearsal together, we played songs from my Fear No Evil days. We did Streetwise and Metal Street, and I think we might have done See Me Cry. I had also written two new songs, pretty much back-to-back. I'd written one song, which is what I'm going to be talking about here, Alone in the Night, and then shortly after that wrote This Time's for Keeps, but that wasn't ready for that initial rehearsal. However, Alone in the Night was. So this is a very special song, as it was the very first song I ever wrote all the lyrics to. I had written songs musically before, but I had never written a song with all the lyrics. Usually my mom helped me with that. But I wrote a song about a particular night. That's what Alone in the Night is about. It's been a very popular song. I've played that in several bands. Even up until recently, just at my last show in June, Xterra played that at our show. So it's still played quite a bit and people really like it. A lot of people say they like it because they relate to feeling alone, feeling like an outcast. And that's great, because looking at it now, yeah, that definitely fits. But ironically, when I wrote the song, that's not what I had in mind. The reason I'm here at Cedar Crest High School is this is the high school I went to. As I've talked about before, it was not a good experience for me. I was bullied here. I never fit in. And just felt like an outcast completely. But I remember very clearly, it was homeroom class, and I was writing lyrics to this song about a particular night. And what happened on that night, I was at Roma Pizza, which I will broadcast from on another time. And that's a special place to me because a lot of my friends and I used to go there and have pizza. And in fact, that's where I met Jack and Bob, who ended up joining the Boardwalk Nights once Cry Wolf broke up. So it's kind of ironic that the first song I wrote while in Cry Wolf would be the place that I'd meet the future members of the band that would be my band after Crywolf. So that was kind of cool. But anyway, the story behind this song is I was out having pizza with my mom and some friends, and a situation went down. I won't go too far into it, but it was a situation that some things were going on behind a friend of mine's back. And I knew about it, but didn't want to get in the middle, didn't want the friends I was with at that time to be angry with me for telling stories, you know, gossiping. And I didn't want my other friend to get mad, so I just kind of kept myself quiet. But it was a very tense and very weird situation, and that's what I wrote the song about. Alone in the night, you feel tension in the air. I feel it too. You have suspicions that all of your friends have just walked out on you. Now, it wasn't on me particularly that I felt anyone walked out on, but I felt very much in the middle of a bad situation and felt so much tension in the air that night. So that's what that song was about. It was the very first song that I wrote while in Crywolf, and it was one of those special songs like Run and Hide and Heartbreaker. It's, you know, the first song that I write when I'm in a new band kind of lets me know it's going to be okay. If I can write a really good song at the beginning of a new band, I believe that everything will be all right. And that's how it was with Alone in the Night. Fear No Evil had just split up, and I was worried, am I still going to be able to do it? Am I still going to have it? And Alone in the Night came. It was the first song I wrote music and lyrics for. And musically, I think it was very inspired by Dokken. And that's the way I try to sing it, the way that they would have sung it. And lyrically, I told you the story about that. So that was a very, very cool time period. And I hope you enjoy this. The version of the song, Alone in the Night, you're going to hear is the very first time it was played in front of people. It was at the Rockathon at the Quality Inn in Lebanon, PA. So I hope you enjoyed this. And if you're liking these behind-the-song stories, please click subscribe and click like. And remember, food for thought, thought from food. God bless you all.
Rockers for the next couple of hours, Bill Hunt, Bob Harvey, Henry Steiner, Crywolf!